Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2373, reaction video to Dueling Excel 58, sort with a formula. Well, hey, it's Friday. It should be Duel 195, and that is all set up for next week. There's a kind of video on YouTube that's called a reaction video. It's just someone sitting there listening to a song for the first time, and you watch them react. So, since I'm going to be missing the Dueling Podcast today, let's do a reaction video to something from December 2010, Duel number 58, sort with a formula. Let's go. Hey, same theme song.
Hey, welcome back. It's another Dueling Excel podcast. I'm Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel. We'll be joined by Mike.
Look how small the video is back then.
This is episode number 58, Sort with a Formula. All right, so here's the question. Mike sent this over.
Wow. 10 years. That's a lot of bad eating right there.
Formula that will sort, but keep the original data order.
All right, we're trying to sort with a formula. Obviously, this one's going to be a lot easier today with dynamic arrays.
Rank function.
All right, so the rank function. The problem with the rank function is that if there's a tie, it gets the same rank, and you have to do something to mitigate that. I'm probably going to use Countif here. And then once we get the unique numbers, a VLOOKUP over on the right-hand side to figure out which name is associated with the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Seems pretty straightforward. Let's fast forward a little bit. Look,
automatically
33 sorts
formula
to the top. That's
but
good.
It starts to fail when we have a tie. Right? So you have two people getting NAs.
See, you can't even see the problem because my head's in the way. Today, we know how to move that picture in picture
formula
up to the top or to the other top.
This in if,
yep,
how many
there's
numbers
the count if,
above
although I have an equal sign
so
instead of a plus sign.
C dollar sign 4 to C4.
See how long it takes for me to figure that out.
Is equal to C5. What that will do.
Oh, didn't work, Bill. And look, I can't even see it. I'm just looking. Oh, there it is. All right, like I predicted, rank plus count if, and then a VLOOKUP, the old way to sort with a formula.
Be
interested to see what Excel is Fun comes up with here.
Thanks,
hey, there's Mike Gurman.
Not a fun
10 years ago.
I love the solution. It's
that's his
use
old office
rank,
at Highline College.
The count if and the VLOOKUP. Everyone knows those functions.
Originally,
and you
we recorded a lot of Dueling Excel podcasts right in that
right,
office each year.
I'm going to do an array formula and trying to do two different formulas here. D4, so I'm going to say
Mike was always
a
fan of rows. I would always just
that's
use row.
That reference is locked. D4, that one is not. That means an expandable range. So as we go down, it'll go from 4 to 4, which is one row, 4 to 5, which is 2. That is our number incrementer. Copy it down. I'm going to do the keyboard shortcut, Control-Shift-4. That gives me a currency format.
Ooh,
all right, now.
Control-Shift-4
I'm going to try
currency
the index
format. That's a good one.
Index. Move cursor on
yeah, this
drag.
Shift-drag thing, that's
that
still confusing me.
Drop it. You can see it's hard to drop that.
It looks like it confuses Mike too. Let's fast forward.
Oh, there it is. Right there. There it is. Comma. And what if I use the match?
So first he uses match but he knows
say, hey,
that this
function,
isn't going to work.
Look up that comma within this range right here.
Because
F4,
the duplicate
comma,
issue.
Zero. That'll return the ordinal position. The problem is when I copy this down, it gives me Lee because match, when you put a zero, these are not sorted numbers.
By the way,
so when you put a zero, it says
2300 videos, I've never said ordinal position.
First one. So now I need to do
until
something
this
slightly
one
different here. If that's true, then what do I want? I want the row. The problem with row right here, F4, is that that'll give me row 4, 5. So I'm going to, that won't work, so I'm going to subtract from it the row. Now notice what this will do is this will give me 4 minus 4, which is 0. So that won't work, and I want 1 here.
So I wonder right there why he didn't point to B3.
Right,
that seems like that would have been natural.
Looking at
so
right,
gives you
so
Lee
all I
and
need
Sue
is a K here. Give me what am I going to
so
count?
It's
I'm going to
get the first and second number. All of the things that
colon,
weren't numbers get thrown out.
Comma this. All right, and then that's the yep K. Close off.
Bring it home.
Close off on the index, and that's it. Now I have to. This is an array formula, and the reason why it's an array formula is this if function logical test. We gave it more than one true and false. So boom, you have to use Control Shift Enter. I'm holding Control Shift and Enter.
Lee,
right, Lee,
Sue, Mary,
Mary.
Yep,
Lee,
John, Joe,
Sue,
it works.
Mary.
Nice
right
job,
so
Mike.
Like it worked. If you're in 2010, this small can be replaced with the aggregate function.
Oh, that's why I always thought aggregate came in 2013, but obviously it was there in 2010.
See how to do that aggregate. All right, I'll throw it back over to Mr. Excel.
This is great. So over here down in the lower left-hand corner, it's like I can't even understand the formula. I don't even react to the formula.
Sure,
I just reacted to Mike's attempt to
shift
drag that information.
Hold down the shift key, go to the right edge, drag right, let go of the mouse, but not the shift key.
What? That was four whats right there. I remember this old office in Uniontown, Ohio. I was about 10 feet away from a highway. You could hear the trucks rushing by. I would try and look up the road for when the traffic light turned red. I knew I had 60 seconds of silence. Well, there you have it from 10 years ago. So small. It was really designed to fit on an iPod. Let's take a look at how we do this today. This is really unfair. Bill from 2020 dueling with Mike and Bill from 2010. All right, thanks to the new dynamic arrays, this is gonna be super easy. This is the array that we wanna sort. We wanna sort by the second column. We wanna sort in descending sequence, like that. And it's perfect, and if there's a tie, if we have Joe and Mary with the same amount, it's going to put them in the same sequence that they were originally. So Joe first, and then Mary. No worries about rank and countif or small or anything like that. Well, hey, I hope you found this entertaining. Next week, we'll be back with a real Dueling Excel podcast. We got a great one, at least three different solutions for that. So I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Dueling Excel podcast from Mr. Excel, and Excel is fun.